Welcome to those of you who worship with us often and to those of you who are worshipping here for the first time or for the first time in a long time. And welcome too to all those who are worshipping online. This service is being recorded and will be broadcast on our YouTube channel on Friday evening at 6 o'clock. So if you enjoy yourselves here, you're very welcome to watch again. But please don't take any photos or video during the service. You can follow the order of service in your Evensong booklet. We're currently halfway down page 3, and the service continues with the psalm appointed for this evening, the first 22 verses of Psalm 37.
Thank you. book of the prophet Isaiah, chapter 52, beginning at verse 13. See, my servant shall prosper. He shall be exalted and lifted up, and shall be very high. Just as there were many who were astonished at him, so marred was his appearance, beyond human semblance, and his form beyond that of mortals. So he shall startle many nations. Kings shall shut their mouths because of him, for that which had not been told them they shall see, and that which they had not heard they shall contemplate. Who has believed what we have heard, and to whom has the arm of the Lord been revealed? For he grew up before him like a young plant, and like a root out of dry ground. He had no form or majesty that we should look at him, nothing in his appearance that we should desire him. He was despised and rejected by others, a man of suffering and acquainted with infirmity. And as one from whom others hide their faces, he was despised, and we held of him no account. Surely he has borne our infirmities and carried our diseases, yet we accounted him stricken, struck down by God, and afflicted. But he was wounded for our transgression, crushed for our iniquities. Upon him was the punishment that made us whole, and by his bruises we are healed. All we like sheep have gone astray, we have turned to our own way, and the Lord has laid on him the iniquity of us all. Here ends the first lesson.
The second lesson is written in the letter of Paul to the Romans, the 15th chapter, beginning at the 14th verse. I myself feel confident about you, my brothers and sisters, that you yourselves are full of goodness, filled with all knowledge, and able to instruct one another. Nevertheless, on some points I have written to you rather boldly by way of reminder, because of the grace of God given me by God to be a minister of Christ Jesus to the Gentiles in the priestly service of the gospel of God, so that the offering of the Gentiles may be acceptable, sanctified by the Holy Spirit. In Christ Jesus, then, I have reason to boast of my work for God, for I will not venture to speak of anything except what Christ has accomplished through me to win obedience from the Gentiles. By word and deed, by the power of signs and wonders, by the power of the Spirit of God, so that from Jerusalem and as far around as Illyricum, I have fully proclaimed the good news of Christ. Thus, I make it my ambition to proclaim the good news, not where Christ has already been named, so that I do not build on someone else's foundation, but, as it is written, those who have never been told of him shall see, and those who have never heard of him shall understand. Here ends the second lesson.
I believe in God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, and in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Ghost, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, dead, and buried. He descended into hell. The third day he rose again from the dead. He ascended into heaven, and sitteth on the right hand of God the Father Almighty. From thence he shall come to judge the quick and the dead. I believe in the Holy Ghost, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen.
The Lord be with you.
Jesus Christ. Amen. Let us pray. Echoing the words of the anthem which set the words of the psalmist, like as the heart desireth the water brooks, so longeth my soul after thee, O God. When shall I come to appear before the presence of God? We give thanks that in Jesus Christ we have one who brings us near to God. And so we pray that we and all those for whom we will pray this night will know God's presence with them. Almighty God, your Son has opened for us a new and living way into your presence. Give us new hearts and constant wills to worship you in spirit and in truth. Through Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. Later in that same psalm, we are told to put thy trust in God, for in him is the strength of thy confidence. We pray for the Church of God that it may indeed trust the true and living God. We pray for the mission of the Church here in this Diocese of Oxford, for Stephen, our Bishop, and those who minister with him. And especially today, we pray for the benefice of Albury with Tiddington, Holton, Waterbury, Waterstock and Wheatley, for Nigel Hawkes, the parish priest, and for the life of Wheatley Church of England Primary School. We give thanks for this house of prayer and pray for its mission and worship day by day, giving thanks for those who sustain it, and especially for the academical and lay clerks and for Frideswide Voices. Gracious Father, revive your church in our day. Make her holy, strong and faithful for your glory's sake. Amen. The psalmist cries, my tears have been my meat day and night, while they daily say unto me, where is now thy God? We pray for all for whom life is a struggle, for the sick and those who care for them, continuing to hold in prayer our Sovereign Lord, King Charles, visitor of this house. We pray for those who are weary, those carrying heavy burdens, especially those known to us. Come, Creator Spirit, source of life, sustain us when our hearts are heavy and our wells have run dry. For you are the Father's gift, with him who is our living water, Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. And as this day draws to a close, so we commend ourselves into God's hands. Come, O Spirit of God, and make within us your dwelling place and home. May our darkness be dispelled by your light, our troubles calmed by your peace, all evil be redeemed by your love, all pain transformed through the suffering of Christ, and all dying glorified in his risen life. And we gather our prayers in the words of the grace. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ and our love of God, the fellowship of the Holy Spirit, be with us all evermore. Amen. The Lord bless you and keep you. The Lord make his face to shine upon you and be gracious to you. The Lord lift up the light of his countenance upon you and give you his peace. And the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit be among you and upon those for whom you have prayed this night and always. Amen.